In my opinion, black music is the basis for all music. It has been, that's just the way it is. So I don't think it's something extraordinary for us. I think it's just a part of us.
For the black youth especially to know that we did have a history and that we did great things and that we had great people, and those things were not in the history books when I was in school. And what I'd like to be doing 5 years from now is attempting to rewrite the history books so that they'll know that.
they see something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do. Anger Snuffing Up 7 easy. There's a reason why after 100 channels destroyed, Anger Snuffing Up 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody want to get in a beat with Anger Snuffing Up 7. But you don't take me seriously.
Free, 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 free
Good afternoon. Welcome to another spontaneous broadcast of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the Mighty One, Angel Snub Nub Seth. I don't want to hold you long. In fact, I don't expect nobody to really be listening. We had a long day yesterday. We re-uploaded Soul Liberation Day 2023, beginning at 9 a.m. I believe it's like 4 hours long. And if you have not watched Soul Liberation Day 2024, I would hope that you would do so on this channel. And then we went live at 2:30, speaking about our mental health in the soul black community, my personal experience. Then we had an exclusive at 7 in the evening on the topic of Warf Deen Muhammad, the son of Elijah Muhammad, leader of the Nation of Islam. The topic was, did his son, Warf Deen Muhammad or Wallace Deen Muhammad, did he destroy, did he cause the fall of the Nation of Islam? And our special guest was our brother, elder, Omar Shamsuddin. I hope that we, and I know I was very, I enjoyed the conversation and the history lesson that our brother, elder Omar, brought to us last night. And we hope to continue to invite him, and he comes to talk with us because he is living history. He does not have to reflect from books, get the documentations, and he lived much of the things that we read about. Personal insider experience. And even myself, because of my age, there are things that I experienced firsthand. I don't have to research. I live the history. We should take advantage of all our people who have age on them and ask them about their experience in the history that we read about in real time. And one day, you will be able to tell younger people, well, I was doing this when Barack Obama was the first black president of the United States. Or I was doing this when World War III broke out. You live in it in real time. There are still those who are alive that lived through World War II, the Vietnam War, all these things that we read about. There are still people who actually lived the Vietnam War, that lived World War II. There are people who are alive that actually marched with Dr. King, who are alive. Most people, it is my experience, most people don't like talking about their life. They don't like talking about their life experience. Because I know my personal family, they really didn't tell us children too much of anything about their life experience. Just only recently that a few say a little something. I don't know whether they are embarrassed or some people just don't like talking about what happened in the past. But it is important that we learn, and we should have our children interested in the history, because as the old saying goes, those who don't know history, something to that effect, I'm paraphrasing, are bound to repeat it. So we should, no child, every child should have some kind of interest. They need to know what happened in the past. And what better start knowing who your own family is? How did you become, and why are we the way we are today? Most of us, we don't know, and most of us, we don't care. But I would encourage a certain amount of us, we should learn and we should know. So it is important that we bother, while he's here, our brother Omar, because there's so much experience in life, not only historical. Well, actually, it is historical, because all our lives are historical. Our experience. All of us have an autobiography, a biography. All of us have a history. And it could be the history of somebody who's not famous that might inspire greatness in somebody. Because I know for myself, I became and want to become a charitable person because somebody in my childhood was charitable to me. And I wish to continue that behavior because it was good. It had an incredible effect on me. And that charity came from a black man. And I'm living in a time where soul brothers are demonized. We are viewed as savages. We are viewed as inhuman, but I can stand strong and proud to say that a black man, that a soul brother, reached out to a child that was not his and demonstrated charity. And that small act of kindness has influenced me all my life. So we should take advantage of our elders while they're here. I wish I had more communication, more interaction with some of my elder brothers and sisters who are no longer here. And maybe they would have been able to tell and talk about some of the things that they have experienced that could help us in our living. I don't want to hold us long. I just want to make a point. We invited our brother, an elder, who clearly has a lot of respect for this platform. We don't have to 100% agree upon nothing, but there's mutual respect. Unfortunately, in the black community, the soul community, especially the black conscious community, there is no mutual respect. There's a competition. I'm smarter than you. Look what I know. There's a person out there in the wind who wants to be greater than myself, and tells us that Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is incompetent. Angel Snuff Nuff 7 no longer qualifies to represent what we created here on this platform. They can do better. A competition. A coup. An assassination. Instead of a brotherly discussion, instead of coming together so that we can move forward in unison, so that we can accomplish a goal. Instead of helping the leadership, because I know better, we want to take over. So we saw a little bit of some of this, a little taste, because I'm curious, what is it that you have that's better? Your plan, your vision. And all I saw, or all I seen, was a bunch of documentation and paperwork. Saw no attempt at, no plan to do anything, no vision, no purpose, just a bunch of documents about what somebody did in the past. Any of us can go to the library. We can go on the internet and find documents about what somebody did in the past who didn't achieve nothing. They didn't gain nothing. But going to the library and digging up documentations is nothing but feel good. Church rhetoric. What does it, how does it, what purpose does it serve? So that you and I may accomplish the goal. When I'm filing a court case and I show you my documents, the paperwork, I can show you each motion is designed to cause this effect. But when you just come to a YouTube channel and slide a bunch of documents, how does this relate? What does this do to help us achieve a goal? When I'm filing my court papers, I can show you each step, each motion, each sentence, and tell you how this is going to accomplish my goal. I can show you my vision. I can show you the purpose. If your documentation does not do that, then your documentation is worthless. It's just a show. It's just entertainment. Look at me. Look at what I know. There are a lot of people that know. There are some people who know how to fix a car. But if you give them a car to fix, the car's still up on blocks. There are people who know certain martial arts, but they can't defend themselves. But they know. They know the kata. They know the different moves. But they can't fight. So showing documents on slides does not mean you know how to fight. It means you know this and you know that, but you don't know how to apply what you know. But we will see if there's application within the next 6 months to a year. We will see, since these are better. And I heard a person say, you're changing the paradigm. We want to see the change within the next 6 months to a year. And I don't mind joining that. I will help you. Because it's about achieving the goal, the purpose, and making the vision real. It's not about my ego. I can easily say, wow, I was wrong. You got it going on. Let's do it that way. No problem. I have no problem with that at all, as long as the job gets done. But it's sad, because of our arrogance, I want to be the leader. Look at me. Look what I know. Always in competition with somebody. And that's why you're not going to go anywhere. Because you really don't understand. You hear about the Mississippi campaign, but you really don't know. You hear about the Mississippi campaign, but you really don't understand the foundation. And with all your paperwork and documentation, what foundation is it sitting on? I don't mean to hold you long. I just want to make a point. Shout out to Twin Pyramid, the Deacons of Reality. Shout out to our chat room. Shout out to, matter of fact, I'm glad I forgot to turn my Facebook on. Let me turn Facebook. I forgot to turn Instagram and Facebook on. Wow, okay. All right, Facebook, Instagram, welcome to another spontaneous broadcast of the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. We had on the program last night our elder brother Omar Shabazz. And I enjoyed that conversation. I hope that you enjoyed that conversation as well. I want to respond to a comment that Brother Omar made. And when he made the comment, some of you watching the live stream, you noticed on my face that I wanted to respond to what Brother Omar was saying, but I really couldn't. I really couldn't respond to what Brother Omar was saying because it's outside the topic. And I didn't want the topic to turn into some religious debate, you know, belief debate type thing. And there was a brother that he invited to the platform who offered nothing to the topic, really. He wanted to debate and argue probably about the teachings of the Nation of Islam or something to that effect. That's not what the topic was about. The topic was about Elijah Muhammad's son. Did he or did he not cause the fall of the Nation of Islam? That was the topic. It was not about our religious beliefs and what we believe in and what we think our opinion. It was about Brother Omar's personal experience in real time during this period of time. That's what it was about. But Brother Omar, because he is a religious person, they can't help themselves. They cannot help themselves. You know, religious and spiritual people, they have to express their religiosity. They have to express their spirituality. They have to express their teachings, their beliefs. And I didn't want to get into that conversation. And I know the other brother, what's his name? Just Us. I know he's very spiritual type person. I'm familiar with him. But this last night was not it was not appropriate. That's not what the topic was about. I like to stay on topic. And we did invite him. He can come back and we can talk about this. But I would advise you not to do so, because we're not going to allow you, not here, to get that off. You're not going to do that here. This is the reality's tip on earth. You're talking about belief, speculation, theory, I assume. We are about facts to the best of our ability. And I very much doubt he wants to come back here and do that. Most times people like that, they want to interrupt another topic and bring a distraction. So I had to cut him off. You can come back. He can come back and bring the spirits and the spooks and the aliens from dimension Naruba, whatever. You're not going to get that off here. The only thing you can do is get angry and upset. You're not going to get that off here. So I held back because Brother Omar is the guest. And I let him talk as a guest. But I want to respond to something that he said. And he said it with passion. And he said it with sincerity. But just because you are passionate, just because you are sincere about something, doesn't make it true. And what he told us last night, he said that the human being, we need a belief in a higher power. We need a belief in God in order to go to the next level or to function or be inspired to do great things. We need to believe in God, some kind of creator, some kind of power. Is this true? We come into this world knowing nothing. You don't even know that you are alive. Your body just responds naturally. I need milk. I need a breast. your doo-doo, and your pee-pee. Naturally. And you cry. You don't even know you're alive. Because there's nothing in the brain at all. Nothing. So if there's nothing in the brain, where is this connection to a higher power? To some creator? The only thing we are attracted to as a child, as a baby, is our mother and the need to feed ourselves. That's the only higher power that we know. So it is no shock to me that the last words from George Floyd, the last words from Tyre Nichols was mama. Because that's the only power, higher power that we know. Now, once we come out the womb into this universe, being among other human beings, there are many influences, many higher powers, like the liquor store, like crack cocaine. I got to get the information and do the research, the library, Google. There are many higher powers, the police officer, daddy. But as a baby, the only higher power that we know of is mama, that we know. We come out into this world and another man or woman tells us about some invisible being, some creator to believe in. We never met. We can't verify. We come into a world where we are conditioned from a baby to believe, not know, to believe. Because they can't show you nothing. You can see mama. You can tell mama. You can hear mama's voice. You feel her lips on your face. Cute little baby, my baby. You get nothing from this higher power. From the invisible force. From the spiritual world. You are taught that. Your condition, that you need that. Like some of us, you need to drink alcohol. You want to feel good? Drink this Hennessy, this wine. You're conditioned to get drunk and chase drugs. We didn't come out the womb wanting drugs. Liquor and alcohol, pornography. We didn't come out the womb for that. We are conditioned. These are ideas sold to us by other people, human beings. We don't have to be taught about sex. As you grew up, your body, it will guide you that way. Your mother and father don't have to teach you. Your body, the changes, the hormone. Naturally, you'll be drawn to a man, you'll be drawn to a woman. It'll happen naturally. You don't have to be taught. It's natural. You have to be taught how to control. You have to be taught responsibility. But you don't have to be taught about a sex drive. It's going to happen to all of us as we mature. But with the belief in a supreme being and a creator, that's conditioned behavior. That's taught behavior. That's learned behavior. If it was natural, you don't have to teach me about it. It'll come to me just like my sex drive. Just like when you was an infant and you reached out for that breast. It'll be natural, but it's not natural. And then you have numerous belief systems, spiritual systems, which one, all of them are claiming, we the right one, baby. And the Quran says, Allah is not the author of confusion. But clearly this is confusing as hell, because even within a dominant belief system, there's various factions. You have something like Islam, all kinds of different Muslims. You have the Hebrew Israelites, all kinds of different Hebrew Israelites. Christianity, all kinds of different Jews. Which one do you choose? When it's natural, you don't have to choose. I don't have to choose about a sex drive. I don't have to choose about reaching out for a breast. Really any breast, because you don't know if that's your mother or not. Although you know that you need to eat. Any breast would do. So who cares? But you don't have to be taught. So Brother Omar says to us, we need to believe in a higher power to function as a human being. This is conditioned behavior. It's like if you give a child a crutch who is not crippled, and you tell them early in life, you can't walk without this crutch. Then that child, even though that child can walk without a crutch, the child will take the crutch and begin to use the crutch because they are taught you can't walk without the crutch. And even as an adult, when it's very clear you can walk without a crutch, you're still going to hold on to the crutch because you was conditioned. I can't do this without this stick. And that's why we think the way that we do, because we have been conditioned for thousands of years that we need to look up and believe in some invisible force and to become reliant on this force. And we can't do nothing ourselves. We are taught we shouldn't be arrogant and love ourselves. Whatever we do in life, we should give that credit to God or some person. We come into this world with our brain. All life forms come into this life with what they need in order to survive. The human being is the only life form on this planet that is telling us you can't survive unless you believe in an alien, some kind of superior force in the universe. A tiger don't do that. A bear could care less about some power in the universe. And a goat and a dog. We come into this world with everything that we need. We don't need nothing from no outsiders. So these persons who believe in that, what have they done for the earth? Since you're connected to this higher power, to this creator, what have you brought to the human family? Well, I will tell you what you brought. You brought confusion. You brought endless wars and hatred, violence. What's that word? Misogyny? That's what you brought from the higher power. Where your beliefs coming from? Are you just walking down the street? La, 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 la. Ooh, an alien is contacting me. No, you was taught by a man. And you got these beliefs from a, not only from, not just from any man, but we got it from foreigners in the desert riding camels. Hebrew Israelite, Moorish Science Temple, the Nation of Islam, Judaism, all that is camel herder religions, foreigners. That's their hallucination. That's their God. If you want to talk about having a connection to a creator, and we all come from the same creator or the same force, then why I have to get my information secondhand? Why I have to have your leftovers? I have to get my information from somebody in the desert. Why I can't be connected to the creator or the force myself? Why I have to give you credit? Read your book that a man wrote, not the force, not the supreme being, but a man wrote, a foreigner. Books, you can't even read without translation. You can't read the Bible without translation. You can't read the Quran without translation. We've never lived in foreign lands. The only land we know about is the United States of America. We've never lived in Africa. We never lived in no Asia or Antarctica or Australia, nowhere. The only thing we know about is the United States of America. So this power should talk, baby, to talk to us the same way it talked to them and people in the damn desert. I don't want their crap. We're different. Just like in your household, you love your children. You're supposed to love your children equal and the same. You're supposed to. That's not really reality. We're going to favor the child that is more successful, that accomplished more like yourself, what you want as a parent. You're not going to be attracted to the child that's doing something that you don't want that child to do. That's reality. But we're supposed to treat all our children the same. So the message that you might have for one child you don't necessarily have the same for another child because the children are different. They have the same mother, same father, you're living in the same house, but everybody is different. So whatever the higher power told the people in the desert, 9,000 miles away from us, why do you think it's the same message when we're different? Those people are much older than us. You don't talk to a teenager the same way that you do a child that's 6 years old. It's a different message because we're different. So whatever God told them, that's between them and their God. Has nothing to do with you and me. The black man and woman, soul brothers and sisters in this country, this God should give us our own message, our own holy book, our own prophet, our own messenger, something, our own message in relation to us. And the closest to that that I know of that we really gotten really was like, I assume like Nation of Islam teaching, but it's revised. It's revised from the foreigners. And you still need their Holy Quran. I don't want your Holy Quran. I don't want no revision. We should have our own message from the universe. And you're quoting foreigners' books. And you don't know why God is talking to them that way. We're different, so we should have a different message. It's common sense. You want to brag to me and try to tell me I'm nothing. I'm stupid unless I'm connected to some force, invisibles, some kind of creator out. And there's no proof that exists. I'm going to deny myself. We call it Santa Claus syndrome. You're an adult person, and you still need a Santa Claus in your life. You still need a teddy to feel comfortable when you go to sleep at night. You still need a nightlight, scared of the dark. Something to bring you comfort. You're an adult person and you still cannot handle the reality of life. So you need somebody to give you comfort. We are adults here. I don't need a teddy bear. I don't need a nightlight. At this time, I don't need a wheelchair. I don't need a crutch. The Jesus said, only the sick need a doctor. If you want to be sick, that's your business. And be a, what they call it, a hypochondriac. Somebody who practices or exhibits hypochondria is somebody who think they are sick. And when doctors diagnose somebody, and clearly they're not sick, they give them fake medicine for the fake sickness. You believe you're sick. You believe that you cannot function without some kind of higher power. So they give you these books. These fake books with these fairy tales and fantasy so that you can function. Because none of it is real. Yesterday, the Nation of Islam celebrated what we call Savior's Day. The same redundant rhetoric we've been hearing for thousands of years, trying to guess. Oh, World War III is coming. Because it looks like. But you don't have to come on TV and talk about what God gonna do. World War III is coming. Most of us, we can guess on our own. The conflict between Ukraine and Russia might break out. We said that here. No big deal. That's common sense tell you that. But World War III might not happen till 100 years later, or it might not happen at all. All this religious stuff is guesswork. Speculation and theory. None of the prophecies of religion and spirituality, none of it has come true. They keep saying the same stuff over and over again. Nobody prophesies that earthquake in Turkey and Syria. That took them all off guard. And they don't really want to talk about it because God didn't do a damn thing for those people. The earth shook and the concrete and the steel fell and over 30,000 people died. Allah didn't do a damn thing. And Allah ain't doing a damn thing now. Who are they waiting on? They are waiting on the Red Cross. They are waiting for people with bulldozers and other equipment. Help me get me out of here. Help get me out of here. The power of the universe ain't doing a damn thing. I'm not going to give nobody credit unless you earn it. Why should I believe in some higher power? And even if there is a higher power, some force out there in the universe, you still don't have to bow down to that. Just because somebody's bigger and stronger don't mean that you have to bow down to them. It sounds like a bully situation. Nobody who cares about you wants you to bow down to them, that they care about you. Only a slave owner, only a tyrant, only a bully. They looking out, a higher power should look out for your welfare like your mama. Your mother was the higher power. And she didn't try to make you weaker. Your mama tried to make you stronger so that you could take care of yourself. So you get to the point, you don't need the higher power no more. Did you hear what I said? That's maturity. The higher power supports you in your weakness to make you strong until you don't need that higher power no more. But a higher power that does not have your best interest at heart want to keep you weak so that you can serve them, so you can be a slave. And that's why all these things are slave teachings. It's slavery. If we are children of God, God wants us to grow up and be God so we can do our own thing, so we can get off the breast. You don't need it no more. You're able to function on your own. Only a tyrant, only a slave owner, somebody that does not have your best interest at heart, want to keep you in a position to keep looking up to them. Your parents, when they are good parents, they don't want you to keep looking up to them. They want you to be able to go out on your own because, first of all, they know that one day they're not going to be here. So they want you to be able to take care of yourself. Good parents. And then they may even leave you some money or some things to help you on your way when they pass. Good parents. But when you're dealing with a tyrant, they want to keep you dependent upon them. You need something? Gotta go to this God, this creator. Because they know that you can't do for yourself. A bad parent. A child cannot stay a child forever. And when a human being physically is an adult, and you still have a child mind, that's a mental disability. When you have the body of a 30-year-old person and you still think like you're 12 years old, that's a mental disability. After all these thousands of years, religion, this spirituality stuff, does not create, produce adults. Still children need somebody. Hoping somebody gonna help you. You need a Santa Claus. We're an adult. Again, those who are spiritual, those who are religious, what have they produced? What do they do that you and me can't do? But they're connected to this higher power. There are many brothers and sisters, there are many people in this world, very successful, famous. They don't believe in no God, no higher power. And you have people that believe in the higher power, homeless, starving on the street. Make it make sense, people. Make it make sense. So I cannot agree with Brother Omar that we need to function. Oh, we can't function as human beings. We have to be connected to some higher source. It's not even your source. You're talking about some stuff that you got from some foreigners. It's not your own personal experience. You got it from foreigners. Very few people, unless they are spiritual, will tell you about their own personal experience. But even if you are, even if they are spiritual, at the root and the foundation of their spirituality, they was taught that by a man or a woman. It did not fall out the sky. And then your imagination takes over. Because you force your brain to accept something that's not real. So your brain says, okay, you want to see it? That's what you want to experience? Well, I'll make it real for you. So you go to sleep. Well, you don't even go to sleep. Sometimes you can be wide awake. And people would drift off into these other realms and things of this nature. So I can't say that your experience is not real. It's real only to you. Nobody else can see because you force your brain to create that world for you because you believe in it so much. And your brain says, okay, I will do that for you. I will create these hallucinations for you. And yes, they are real. Only to you. Nobody can see it. I can't see it. Brother Twin, Return of the Brother, we can't see these. We can't see all. We can't. Your brain can only make that for you. If you think about Mickey Mouse enough, Your brain will create an image. Matter of fact, you might meet Mickey Mouse. And you don't have to go to Disneyland. Just train your brain on Mickey Mouse. Just think about Mickey Mouse. Everything about Disneyland. And your brain will create that for you. And you can go to Disneyland and you don't have to pay that $1,000 fee to go vacation at Disney World. You force your brain to make fantasy reality. If you're a child of God, you can't stay a child forever. You have to grow up to be God. You have to grow up to be the power in the universe. Instead of always begging and praying to the power. You're supposed to become that power because you're a child. Or are you confused being a child of God with being a slave, a servant? That's very confusing, because a God don't play God. Once you become adult, you respect your parents and you love your parents, but you're an adult just like your parents are. And you go out into the world and create your family and do your thizzy. You become an adult. They don't pay your bills no more. You pay your own bills. You buy your own car. You don't need your parents no more. So if we are children of God and grow up to be God, then when are you going to get to the point where you don't need that no more? You don't need God like that no more. Unless you are a slave. A slave will always need their masa. Always. And you say, I only exist to serve God. So you telling me that you exist to be a slave. So you will always be dependent upon your slave master. You a servant. You a sheep. You a slave. So I'm not shocked that people don't understand reality's temple on earth. I'm not shocked that people can't comprehend, because we're talking to sheep. We're talking to slaves. We're not talking to people that want to grow up and be God. They want to be dependent instead of independent. So I'm not shocked, and that's fine with me. People who are sick, because you got to be damn sick if you want to be a slave. Voluntarily, not involuntarily. You want to be a slave voluntarily. And you think somebody's supposed to be impressed because you are a voluntary slave. I serve God. Are we supposed to be impressed when you say that? I'm a servant of the Most High. So we're supposed to be impressed. Basically just told us you a happy slave. That's what you just done. You a happy slave. Thank you. I will pass. We are better than that. We're supposed to be adults, and we're supposed to be healthy. We're not supposed to be sick. So why are you acting sick? Why are you acting like a slave if these things are not you anymore? When you become an adult, when you become yourself, you don't need the Holy Quran, because you become the Holy Quran and more. You don't need the Bible no more, because you become that and then some. These books are for the sick. These books are for the children. I'm an adult. Don't need that no more. Because now I'm an adult. I'm God. Don't need that stuff no more. I can write my own book. When you become an adult, now you write your rules for your children the same way your parents wrote the rules and how they want you to live in their house. Now you adult. Now you do that for yours. So here on this platform, we're adults. We write the policy. We write the rules. Nobody dictate me and tell me who and what I am. You take stuff from foreigners. That's not yours. Then you get angry when they tell you this is how this is supposed to go. It's their stuff. It's not yours. I'm making it better. It's still their stuff. It came from you. Wouldn't have it. It came from them. There's no foreigner ever come to this platform and tell me what to do, how to think, and that's wrong because they don't have nothing to do with this platform. Because we have become God here. We've created this planet and this earth. And the former things we have allowed to pass away. Maybe you will get that one day. You a child. Grown folks here. That's why you don't understand. You ever saw children look at you because you're an adult, you grown, and children look at you and a lot of the words you say, they don't understand, they can't comprehend, they just be looking at you. That's what they do with us. What you mean? Could you explain? Because children don't know. As an adult, you're well beyond that child. They don't know. That's what they do to us here. Mississippi campaign? Is y'all going to Mississippi? Twin, when y'all moving to Mississippi? Who going to Mississippi? What y'all gonna do? I don't care how simple. I don't care how simple you say it. They can't comprehend. I thought, and I tried to be and present things as simple as possible, but still, there's no vision. There's no plan. What you talk about, Mississippi campaign? What? That's why I can't really get angry. We're dealing with children. The slave on the plantation, I'm going to say this, we're going to get out of here. The slave on the plantation who questioned the slaves that want to run away can't comprehend. They can't comprehend that. I don't know why you want to run away like that. Master John is mean sometimes, but he all right. They let us ride the horses. It ain't that bad here. Why you want to run away to a better place? How you know there's a better place? How you know there's a better place? The soul train never left the station, my brother. The soul train never left the station, my brother. They can't comprehend. They can't comprehend. But they can comprehend thousands of years of past history. They can comprehend that. How old is Reality's Temp on Earth? 15 years. 15 years compared to 100 years and 1,000 years. How old is the Mississippi Campaign Vision? Since 2018. But you can comprehend Kemet, and you can comprehend what those foreigners do and what Africans do and what happened 50,000 years ago. But something in your time period, you can't comprehend. What you talking about? Soul Train never left, my brother. But that train is the only vehicle that can get you where you want to go, because you've gotten on the Metrolink of Africa. You ain't went nowhere. You've been on the caboose of Islam. You've been in the Uber of the Moorish Science Temple, and the list goes on and on. Where have they led you? Where you at? Road to nowhere. So here's a new vehicle designed just for you. It didn't come from a foreigner, didn't come from nowhere. It came from your womb. I'm gonna say this, we're gonna get out of here. You know what it reminds me of? Some of these women that have babies, and all babies are cute except their baby. Oh, did you see Veronica's baby with the little pinky? Oh, that is so cute. Did you see Nadira's baby with the little bonnet and got the little cute face? That's so cute. But they don't think much of their own children, their own baby. So you can put all this foreign stuff from the Arabs, other people in the Middle East, or in China, because some of y'all into Buddha, the Bana faith, whatever they call this stuff. You can put all this foreign stuff on this high pedestal. But when something comes from your own womb, it ain't good enough. Because the soul train came from us. Soul brothers and sisters came from us. Nobody can claim it. And we can make it whatever we want to make it. It has nothing to do with religion. And you are correct. When I talk about soul brothers and sisters, the soul train, I'm talking about this culture, subculture that we created living in America as black men and women, the so-called Negro. And soul religion is part of that culture. I choose to ignore that side because it makes us weak, because it's not real. That's why I ignore that side. You can keep it if you want. It has done nothing for us. It keeps us in a slave-like condition. It's best to get rid of it. And you will see, once you get rid of it, your life is not going to be any different. If you're going to be a success, you're going to be a success. If you're going to be a failure, you're going to be a failure, with or without a belief in God. A belief in God does not determine success or failure in life. I've been more successful, quote, whatever, when I stopped believing in all that stuff. When I believed in it, the only thing it brought to me was disappointment and frustration and less money in my pocket and letting people exploit me. That's all it did. And made me docile. because God is going to save me. And God ain't did a damn thing. If you don't do it, if you don't use your brain to get something done, it's not going to get done. And you can give the universe or God or the creator the credit if you want for what you do. I will give God the creator credit when that chunk do some of this work. Put my videos up on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. When the creator, this power, start doing some of the work, I would give that power credit. Until then, the only one who's going to get credit is the one who's actually doing the work, and that's me. That's us. When the spirit and the spook and the alien and the hobgoblin do some work, I would give them their credit. I'm not going to give credit, and there's no evidence, no proof that these things done a damn thing. That's a disservice to the people that's doing the work. That's a disservice to me. I'm doing all the work. And God ain't did a damn thing. I waited on God when I was incarcerated until I found the right information and did the work. Then I brought an end to that incarceration. God didn't do nothing. And that's a fact. If I thought God did something to help me, I would give God the credit. I'm not going to give God no credit. I'm not going to give no creator. I'm not going to give no spiritual power no credit unless I can show and I can prove that this power actually done something. You give God and the creator and the most high, you give all these things credit and you can't prove nothing. You want to give them credit. Santa Claus syndrome. We know that the parents, we know that a person bring these gifts. There is no Santa Claus. And you do the same thing. Look what Allah done for me. Did your ass work? Did you pay off that credit card? What did Allah do for you? We could do a quick experiment. My God versus your God. I'm going to sit in my chair and you sit in your chair right across from me. And both of us going to call out to our God. We want to eat. Who is my God? Twin Pyramid, brother in the chat room. Deacon of Reality, the return of the brother. Those are my gods. Brothers, I can't get up out of this chair. Can you bring me some Kentucky Fried Chicken and a soda? And they will answer my prayer. I'm still sitting in my chair. And God answered my prayer. And an Uber bring me my Kentucky Fried Chicken and my soda. You pray to your God, Allah, the Most High, Jah, or whatever you want to call him. And you cry to your God and you sit there. And somebody bring you something. Not Jah, not Allah. Another man, just like me, another man bring you some food to eat. And you will say that man, your God sent that man. But then that man will say, no, so-and-so called this order in. What you tell? Allah didn't call this order in. The Most High didn't call this order in. You know, Jah, Yahweh, whatever you want to call it. Frank Simpson, your co-worker, called this in and said that you wanted some Chinese rice. We need to stop playing games and grow up. But there are those who believe in these things for so long They're just going to hold on to it until they die. But there are those of us, we should know better. And when you know better, you can do better. It's simple as that. So with that said, I want to thank you for joining me on this spontaneous broadcast. I really appreciate it. And there might be those who might want to challenge what we say. I would not advise it because you're going to be looking very embarrassed. Go stay with those who believe. Even atheists don't like me. I thought that atheists would like how I talk. Atheists don't like me either. Because atheism is garbage also. Atheism is man-made also. Somebody created that garbage too. So nobody likes Angel Snuffin' Up 7. Because we're keeping it real. And we are surrounded by all of these folks, human beings, trapped in the matrix, trapped in fantasy and fairy tales, the illogical, the unreasonable, and don't even use common sense. As clearly, common sense must not be as common as it once was. Get on the soul train. Help and join Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign. And let us be successful. Let us be a winner. Don't talk about being a winner. Let's stop talking about history and make history. All these folks telling us about history, but they don't know how to make history. We can become the greatest generation ever produced if we do this correctly in the way it needs to be done. And our ancestors will be so proud because they're good parents. They're good parents. So on that note, again, thank you, Return of the Brother, Twin Pyramid, Deacons of Reality, those in the chat room, those who are watching this in the sky, because I'm pretty sure those people that don't like Angel Snuffin' Up 7, they still watch us in the sky. Shout out to our Facebook and Instagram. Shout out to Sister Taji, Josiah and her family out there in California, to our people in London, England, and around the earth. And I know they hate for me to say that, but that's the wonderful thing about the internet. People around the world actually hear The Reality's Temple on Earth. The Reality's Temple on Earth Rumble channels. Rumble is almost like YouTube. And it's a Canadian company. And little by little, more and more subscribers are finding Angel Snuffin' Up 7 and Reality's Temple on Rumble. And I'm glad to be part of Rumble, because it's steady growing. And I already have a platform there. I already have a presence on Rumble. Actually, I think Rumble is more, it's better than YouTube. Don't have all that censorship garbage going on. So we're growing on Rumble, doing pretty well. Look, we represent the truth, reality here. You cannot expect people who believe in fantasy and fairy tales to gravitate toward reality. You just cannot expect that. I'm happy with my 10 subscribers. I'm happy with my 10 views. I'm satisfied. So anytime I see 10 views, I'm all right. You might not be impressed. I'm happy with it. But of course, people like us much more than that. And you will see slowly but surely, if YouTube stopped flagging the channels and stuff, you will see that people will listen to what we have to say. Don't have to support, but they're willing to listen to our message. Because I'm just as charming, I'm just as charismatic, I'm just as lovable as the other folks out here on social media. I want to thank Brother Omar, Elder Omar, for that presentation yesterday. Wonderful presentation. We're going to bring our brother back. And that's it, y'all. Like Porky Pig said, that's all, folks. Our brother Don Cornelius used to always say, as in parting, I wish us love, peace, and soul. And we are 85,000.